We are not here to deceive ourselves. We are here to tell ourselves the bitter truth so that Nigerians will stand for change. Many people have become lovers of Jonathan today. I moved the motion that made Jonathan the acting president of this country. And I was the leader of the group in the House of Representatives that stood and fought back on it that thing must happen that day. That night I had a dinner with the president, with our group. And the president, his first trip to America, my name was penciled. But I said no, I offered Honorable Abba Anas to travel with the president, and he traveled with the then acting president. Then we were good men. Then Pastor Bakari was a good man. But today, because what we did then was not for good luck Ebele Adikiwe Jonathan. It was for Nigeria because it was the constitutional thing to do at the time. It was the right thing to do at the time. And now, when we start criticizing this government, or any other government for that matter, you're now seen as a bad person. Few statistics. I was in the House of Reps, and I was part of those who worked on the budget of 2011. In 2011, we passed a budget for subsidy to the tune of 245 billion. For subsidy. Please listen so that you will understand what I'm saying. We passed a budget for subsidy for 245 billion. But the Jonathan government ended up spending 2.3 trillion. Over 2 trillion above the budget. Anywhere in the world, once you have extra budgetary expenditure that is not approved by the National Assembly, it is immediate punishment. The budgets, the Appropriation Act is a law. People forget that is a law. So any breach or non-compliance with that act is a breach of law. It is irresponsible. Today, as I speak to you, if you remove 2 trillion from the economy of Ghana, Ghana will collapse. But yet, we ended up spending over 2 trillion on what we appropriated. That was my first problem. Second, the Jonathan administration, whether you like it or not, must be criticized. Because the future of my children is involved. Yes. I want a Nigeria where my grandchildren that I may never know will have a life that is structured for them. Yes. Whether the president or any of his ministers or governors are happy or not. In an unjust society, silence is a crime. Yes. As I speak, it's in the Public Service Act that once you are indicted of corruption, you have to be suspended. Today we have a minister in this government, and I'm saying it without fear of people. She has been indicted by six different reports. The first is the KPMG report. KPMG is an international auditing firm. Indicted NNPC, indicted PPPRA, indicted the minister, because the minister is also the chairman of NNPC, the board of NNPC. The second is the Farouk Lawal report. The third is the Senate report on subsidy. The fourth is the Nuhu Ribadu report. The fifth is the Hike Imokode's report. The last and the sixth is the Neiti report. Yet, a minister has been indicted by six different reports. But that minister is still elegantly attired and cosmopolitanly fashioned every Wednesday in diamonds, sitting in the Federal Executive Council under the watchful eyes of an unperturbed president. Are we supposed to keep quiet? We have precedents. When, during the what's the Dutch government? Late past Sunday, Afolabi was indicted in the National Identity Card scam. He was removed as minister. When Fabian Osuji, former Minister of Education, was indicted, he was removed. When Wabara was indicted, he was removed. Even during the Yar'Adua administration, when Professor Grant and Gabriel Aduku were indicted as Minister of Health and Minister of State for Health, they were removed as ministers. Why is the Zenith still a minister in this government? And I am happy that the spokesman of government is here and is going to have a right of reply. As I speak here, I say it with every sense of responsibility that since this government came into power, not one single politically exposed person has been jailed. I challenge. Not one.
This is the beauty of democracy. Some of the things that have been said here concern individuals. Most of the cases are in court. Maybe, as God will have it, as we make progress, there is nothing hidden in democracy. There is something I keep telling everybody. Democracy has long memory. The things you do today, you will still be called to account. Sometimes 10, 20 years after you leave power, they never go away. They never go away, including those in government now and those who are out. So, on all the things that my brother has said, he's not saying it for the first time. I've had him on different theaters. Because this is what you call perfect rabble-rousing. I've had him in different theaters making these proclamations. Some of those cases, like you mentioned, against some of the ministers, they are in court with him. So I don't want to intervene and I don't want to enter them. I have not come here to discuss 2015. I didn't. And I can say all my discussion has nothing to do with it. Because 2015 is in the realm of God. It's in the realm of the people. But my thinking clearly is this. If I feel strongly about certain things like some people do, I will go to a court of law and devil my fingers. I will go to a normal process where those people can be called to account and table them so that it will not just be proclamations. Assuming, for example, that, for example, when Gani felt strongly that some people are responsible for a colleague's death, he took steps and got the law to come on his side. He didn't finish it, but he showed that level of courage and commitment. So I can tell you very clearly, I have already discussed a few things with you here. And I said, the Jonathan government is not perfect. The Jonathan government has not addressed all the problems of Nigeria. No government ever will. But I can tell you that a number of things I have witnessed tell me that the president has a commitment. The last meeting I attended was between him and all the other arms of government. And why did he table? He said, I am not comfortable with cases hanging. Can the judiciary, for example, set up special courts? Let us not be deceived. As I said, I am coming on a long road. I have been on all parts of the ISIS. And so God has placed me here today to be able to say to you, frankly, this is what you have done and this is what is going on in our country. I am not going to compete with anybody in rousing the crowd or shouting. But I can tell you very clearly that after this period, yes, you are free to say no. That is part of why we are here. You are free to say no. You are free to say yes. Even if 99% says no, I will make my point. But subsequently, when the facts are clear, you will see them. Because I used to say that when I said no, certain things will not happen the way they will happen. Some of my colleagues then say, no, they will happen. They didn't happen. I've mentioned some of the instances here. So please, let us find a way of discussing government in the language that will enable people to reason. If you do not, yes, because if you are government, it's my government. So I think it's important to do that.